Hey you guys, it's Sydney. Welcome back to my YouTube channel. Today is a long awaited video for you all. Finally, my natural hair journey. But you know, like, this video is gonna be like long. We're just gonna get right to the start. And if I'm looking down, I have some notes right here because there's a lot to go through. So let's get started. Okay, when I was younger, my parents would brush out my hair. And like, so some pictures I have, my hair was curly, some were straight. I don't really know, like when I was really little, it was really curly. Then when I got through like elementary school, I got like ringlets at the bottom. I don't know, it was weird. But it could be because they're using baby shampoo and like all that stuff that we didn't have back in the day for curly hair. So in middle school, I really noticed a change in my hair, me and my sister actually. It got like this, basically little ringlets everywhere. And so I didn't know how to control that. Basically 2010. I would say I started like venturing out on my hair and finding products to use. Of course, we all go to the store and we see Tresemme on the shelf. We see Flawless Curls Mousse. I'm telling y'all, I use that for like all of middle school. I would straighten my hair a lot in middle school, like once, like every 2 months, all the time. Like it was always straight. I try to do like that snooky bump and I wear my makeup a hot mess. It was just not cute. But I didn't really notice, like I didn't know how to deep condition. I would go get my hair cut like once a year, but they would cut it straight or wet, so it always be uneven. So then one day, like we went to Sally's, and they said, you know, here's this cream. But it was like the generic brand and it would still have like silicone. I thought I was making like my way up to the top, you know, with these products. No, literally my hair was so dry. It was all frizz. And that's because products, not getting trims, just like sleeping on cotton, not protecting my hair, not doing protective styles, just using drying products. And I'm sure I was washing my hair like every so often. Hold up y'all, I gotta fluff my hair, you already know. I don't know what this edge is doing, like it's trying to curl, and then I got this Superman curl, I don't know what's going on. But anyway, so that was my middle school life. Tresemme mousse, all the mixed girls used Tresemme. Literally me and my friend and my sister all were hyped because we used Tresemme. Like, oh my God, you use that too? And like everyone would ask, what do you use? Now I feel bad for telling them Tresemme because no, don't use that. And I would switch it up with like herbal essence. Going through on YouTube, like I would watch Sunkissed Alba, Shameless Maya. I think Shameless Maya is like one of the first people I started watching. But obviously we have different hair types. And this is when I was in high school. I was like, you know what? It's time to go on YouTube. So Shameless Maya and Sunkissed Alba. And then Lissette. Who else did I watch? Lipstick and Curls, she is my go-to, I love her. But then again, none of them have my hair type. And I was struggling trying to find someone with my hair type, and my sister was struggling with her hair type too, because even me and her have different hair types. So we were like, you know what, let's try this out. So it's like 2013, 2014. My first curl cut was like 2014. So for me, like going to a curly hair specialist, I had no idea. I was like, oh my gosh, like this is amazing. I do this more often, like, but my hair grew so much. So it's not like I didn't cut my hair. I started using an OGX biotin and collagen shampoo and conditioner. Motions leave-in, y'all. Motions. Who knows emotions anymore? Literally, my mom gave that to me because she would use that relaxer, but she would give us like the leave-in conditioner spray. And it stunk so bad, like, I don't know why I use that. I started using Shea Moisture. But back then, Shea Moisture was really heavy on my hair. They only had the Crone Style Milk and the smoothie, and it did not work for me back in the day. Like, I thought it did, but now that I look back in pictures, it was so flat because I would literally, here was my routine, wash my hair, put in product, take a paddle brush. Literally, I had like waves. Like, you know how guys have waves? It was like waved from the brush. It was a hot mess. And then to deep condition, we found this stuff called Queen Helene Cholesterol. Me and my sister thought it was the greatest thing ever because I think it has protein. So it did, from all that Tresemme and like not deep conditioning for like 2 to 3 years, literally, it made our curls like bounce because the protein. So yeah, stylers, I would use Curl Hansen Smoothie, Curl Style Milk, but I didn't really know like what to use. And then one day I think I saw someone started using Eco Styler. I feel like it was Shameless Maya, but I don't know. And I was like, you know what? I'm gonna switch it up. So this is when 2015, 2016 rolled around. Still using OGX shampoo, Cantu, and then I started using the Curls Creme Brulee and the Eco Styler Gel, and I got great results. I started co-washing, y'all. I used the As I Am co-wash, and then I loved the Garnier Damage Eraser. Literally loved it so much. It like made my curls just come back, and now they just continue that line, you guys. Even though it's not all curly girl friendly, it still worked for my hair. Like, I don't know why they got rid of it. This is when I discovered this brand called Beautiful Textures at Sally's. And it said wavy, curly, kinky. I was like, that's me. Let me get it. My perfect wash and go was Beautiful Textures Leave-In Garnier Oil and Eco Styler Gel, the clear one. That was my go-to, and I was only washing my hair like once a week, so I kind of got into that hang of that and deep conditioning like starting off. Now that I look back, that leave-in that I loved so much, even though it says it's natural, has dimethicone. So I was just like, wow, like my heart broke. I didn't know what to do. And then like finally, you know, 2015 to 2016 was a very good time for my hair. Even though some of the products weren't sulfate, silicone, paraben free, they still worked for me. And from what I had using Tresemme and Herbal Essence, in 2016, the end of 2016, I think it was the beginning of like January, I discovered Diva Curl. My mom got me the mini kit that came with the No Poo One Condition Styling Cream and Gel. You guys, my hair, it was so amazing. It was like soft, bouncy, defined, like everything I wanted in my wash and go. Just using these one products. So I was like, these are no lie. Like, yeah, they're expensive, but my hair literally changed. Like my texture, everything. I was loving Diva Curl. Like it was just amazing. So then I was like, you know what? It's time for me to invest in my hair. 2017 to now, you all know Diva Curl is still my go-to. I'll use As I Am co-wash. I will do apple cider vinegar rinses. I've been using Shea Moisture's new line. I absolutely love the shampoo and conditioner, especially the conditioner is super thick. And I've been using some Innocence Diva Curl deep conditioner. And then also I've been using Maui Moisture, Shea Moisture, Mielle Bounce Curl. So if I had to go back, I wouldn't change anything because I feel like it's all a learning experience. Now I do like every 3 months I get a trim, but y'all know I usually cut my own hair. Some tips, like be patient because it's not an overnight process. You all who now have the products that we didn't have back in the day, take advantage of that. Don't even bother going and picking up Tresemme shampoo and conditioner because it's gonna dry out your hair. Put the heat down, get trims. Don't wait a year like me because your hair won't go anywhere. The longer your hair gets, the ends are the deadest part of your hair. Take advantage now, quit waiting, cut off that heat damage. You need a deep condition, stay with a regimen. That is my biggest thing. If I have one, your biggest thing would be stick with a regimen. Listen to your hair too. I can usually go a week without washing my hair, but if it's been 3 days and my hair is very dry, I'll go and wash it. I'm not gonna sit here and like push it because I could just break my hair. Drink water. use natural products that work and find what works for you. Look up people who have similar hair types. I'm always open to questions because I feel like I still to this day cannot find my hair type. And no curl is the same, even on your own head. No two curls are the same. But the like Hi Felicia, I watch her all the time. She's the closest person I found to my hair type, the same texture, even though her curl pattern is tighter than mine. The texture of mine is very soft. It's not the coarse like type that a lot of people would think I have. It's very soft. You can literally see. But Hi Felicia is like the first person that I actually found with a softer hair type like mine. So just search for those. You have to want it. Like, don't go into it and give up. It's gonna take time. Also, what really, even today, I look back on these pictures. I used to log my hair, and I still do to this day. When you wash your hair, that day, take a picture. And then go to your app and say, I used what? Camille Rose or whatever. And put the gel, the cream, the leave-in. And then I'll wait 2 days later, take another picture. Just whenever I take pictures, I'll say, oh, day 3 hair. And I refreshed with this. That really helps me because even from this time to 2017, my hair type has changed. So I can always go back on those pictures and say, oh, well, I used Shea Moisture here. Let me try it again and see how it does. You know what I'm saying? So like, you never know if it's gonna work or it's not. So it's also good, like it's always good to log your hair. But just make sure you stick with it and you don't get discouraged. Don't sit here and compare your hair to other people because I used to do that all the time. I'll say I hate my hair, like I want it curlier, I want it looser, or I want it tighter, whatever. Because all these pictures that I saw on Instagram, but you gotta know to embrace what you have. It is your own, God made you this way. Don't like get discouraged. Don't let people tell you what you can and can't do with your hair. If you want to wear braids, wear braids. If you want to cut your hair, cut your hair. If you want to go and dye your hair. I don't care, it's your hair. No one at the end of the day can tell you or stop you from doing what you want with your hair. Literally, I always get told you don't have mixed girl hair. What is mixed girl hair? I know mixed girls who have straight hair, wavy hair, my hair, 4C hair. So don't let someone, because I used to get discouraged. This girl told me, well, you and your sister don't have mixed girl hair, and she was mixed. And I'm just like, but we're mixed. So this is mixed girl hair. I'm confused. So don't let people discourage you. Just let all that go. It's really not worth it. Just find what works for you. Find the best things that work for you. And switch up your products because I did not used to do this. I used the Ego Styler year round. No. Switch it in the fall, winter, summer, and spring. You have to switch up your hair products because with the weather, your hair changes. So basically in the winter, I'll try and do more heavier like creams. In the summer and spring, I can get away with gels. I love gels. I feel like gels just give my hair that hold that I need to get through the week of my wash and go. So yeah, I hope y'all enjoyed this video. Sorry if I got off topic a lot. I'm just, my brain is like, it can't do one thing. Like I think of things at the end that I should have said at the beginning, but just bear with me. So yeah, I hope y'all enjoyed this video. Thank you all for watching. Please subscribe, go to that button. If you like this video and you want to see more videos like this, or you just want talk throughs, I'm all for it. Let me know. All right, you all, I'll see you in the next video. Bye.